Hi everyone, welcome to Python programming series. In today's class we are going to discuss about lists. A list is used to store multiple data items in a single variable name. For example, we are going to store a is equal to 10. That means we are storing a single value in a variable name, right? Instead of that, we are going to store multiple values in single name under single. Example, I am going to take here my list is equal to, I can store data items, for example, more than one value I am going to store under single name like this, and I am going to display my list. Just the data is going to be coming like this. And what is the type of my list here? It is going to be written as a class list here. Okay, this is very similar to the arrays concept in C programming language, but here the difference is in C language, if you are giving that, if it is an integer, we can store only integer values. If it is a float, we are going to save only float values. That means homogeneous values we can store here, but in list we can store multiple different data item values also like this. For example, I am going to store here one integer, one string, one floating value and one boolean value also. I can store it, any type of data I can store here. I can display the data like this also. Okay, this is the usage and difference between array and my list. There are number of functions when we are dealing with lists. I am going to take one more list here, my list is equal to, I am going to take a number of values here like this, and here I am going to discuss about a number of functions which are going to applied on the list here. The first one is the length function. I am going to find how many values in that. There are totally 8 values are there. We are going to write here length of the list name. It is going to be represent how many values are in the list here simply. And here max of my list. What is the maximum value in the list? That is going to be 8. And the same thing here also, min of my list. Simply it is also returned the value that is going to be 1 here. The min and max and sum is there. Sum of my list. That means I am going to add all the elements in the list. I am simply adding that using that sum of my list function. Okay, these three functions are going to be work when all the list items are going to be a similar data item. For example, if all are integers, all are float, then only these three will work. Okay, and the next one is append. That means I am going to add one more data item into the list. How I am going to add it? My list dot append of. For example, I am going to add 100. Yes, the function not returning anything here. It is applicable to the my list here. If I am going to add my list dot append of 100, the 100 is added to the list as a last element. That means it is going to be add 100 to the last element of the list. Okay, this is append function. And the next one is my list dot insert of. Now I am going to add a value wherever I want. I am going to give some index position. First one is the index position. Two values I am going to pass here. For example, 2, 200. I am going to insert 200 at the position of 2. That is based on index position here. Just observe here, this is 0 index, this is first index, and this is second index. Simply just observe here my list. Here 3 is not deleted. If you observe here, 3 is not deleted. 3 is, and everything is moving here. And we are going to place 200 in the index 2 position. We are going to place 200 in the second index position. And one more thing that is going to be extend. For example, I have two methods, two lists like this. I am going to add these two lists into one list. For example, if you go for append, I am going to add like this. Just observe here, this total list is going to be added as one data item, but I want the 4, 5, 6 also as the same thing. Items of the list, for example, here I am going to add A and B like this, and I am going to add extend of B. If you observe here, now 4, 5, 6 is not a list here. 4, 5, 6 is single elements that are in the B that are going to be added to the A here. That is the use of extend function. Here, using all these three methods, that is append, insert and extend, we are adding values to the list. Now I am going to delete the values. What are the functions there? For the first one is a pop function. My list dot pop off. It is going to be return that, for example, what is my list value? My list is containing the values like this. I am going to apply this one. What is my list? This is the my list. What is the last element here? 8, right? 8 is going to be deleted. What is the last value that is going to be deleted after we are executing that my list dot pop off? Just observe here, there is no 8 in the list now. Why? Because the pop method is going to delete what is the last value is going to be deleted here. Okay, and when you are not passing any arguments, it works as it is going to delete the last value. For example, I am going to write here pop of 2. Now what element it is going to be deleted? At index position 2, there is a 200, it is going to be deleted that value now. For example, now my list, if you observe, there is no 200 in the list. If you use only pop off, it is going to be deleted the last value. If you pass any value here, my list dot pop off 2, it is going to be delete the value at that index. Okay, and that is the two different ways we can use a pop method. And the next one is, for example, I am going to write here a list like this. Now a dot remove of 1 here. I am going to remove the value 1. This is a value based deleting. The pop and pop off methods are deleting that based on the index here. This method is going to delete the last value. This method is going to be delete the value at that index. But now using the remove method, it is going to be delete the value 1 here. For example, I am going to execute it. What is the A value here? Here, the A value is, the list value is containing 1 here, and this value is going to be deleted, but this 1 is not deleted. When I am going to execute it again, if I am going to execute it again, it is going to be deleted. It is going to be delete the first value. For example, now I am going to delete 2 here. It is going to be delete. What is the first occurrence of 2 here? This value, right? This value is going to be deleted, but this value is not deleted. For example, if I am going to execute it, just look at here. Okay, remove is a value based deleting. Okay, and the next one is, for example, what is A here? What is my list is like this. And I am going to write here my list dot reverse off. Just observe the my list again, the values are going to be reversed. Very simple, right? My list dot reverse, the total values are going to be in a reversed order simply. And for example, I am going to write my list dot sort off. If you observe here, All the values are in a sorting order, that is going to be in an ascending order every time. Okay, my list dot sort of, my list dot reverse off. We can easily reverse it and we can easily sort it also. Now I am going to find, for example, A is there. I am going to find at what position the 2 is, or 3 is. For example, I am going to create one more. One again. For example, I am going to write at what position the value is. The what? for example 2 is a dot index of 2. I am going to find the element 2, the value 2 is at what position. I am going to find that at what position it is. For example, this is 0 index 1 2 3. The value 2 is at index 3 here. The value 2 is at index 3. For example, I am going to write here 51. 51 is there, right? It is going to be at fifth position. For example, the value is not in the list. What is the output here? It is going to be give an error. What is that? 100 is not in the list. Okay, simply before executing this one, we are going to search that is it available in the list or not. Now I am simply finding that 100 in list. It is going to be search, is 100 in the list? No, then it is going to be return, my list. 100 is not in the list, right? My list is this one. 100 is not in the my list. That's why it is returned false here. For example, 5 in my list. 5 in my list. It returns true here. Okay. For example, again, 100 not in the list. Yes, 100 is not in the list, right? That's why it is returns true here. For example, I am going to write here. 5 is not in the list. 5 is already in the list. That's why it returns false here. Okay. In and not in. These are that. And for example, I am going to write here 1 comma 0 comma 1 comma like this. A is equal to any of A. It is going to find that the value is going to be true here. Why it is returns true? If any value, it is working as a logical OR gate here. If any value in the list is true, at least any value, yes, one value is true, that's why it is going to be returned true here. For example, all of A, then now it returns a false. Why it returns false here? All the values are true. No, one value is a zero value, right? That's why it returns a false here. Okay, these are the functions so we are going to discuss. We are discussing here, and in the next class we are going to discuss about what is the how we are going to do indexing and negative indexing, and how to read from the keyboard, how to read the data from the keyboard to add into the list and everything. And that's it for video. Thank you very much.